everybody! I will start today with a guitar in my hands. And you know why? Because I'm happy. Because, yes, who is here with me today? HunnyB! Hello, HunnyB! Good to see you! You can give your greetings to all Brazilian people.
Hello, Brazil!
Let's go to starting to talk a little bit about All Together Now.
Yeah, sure. So I did season one and two of All Together Now here in the UK. And it was intense, full on, but so much fun. Everybody was amazing, great vibes, great personality. You know, when you have so many people in a room from all different places in the, you know, in the country, you think, oh my gosh, there's going to be friction. There's going to be like some kind of, I don't know, sometimes you might get a little bit of cattiness or whatever, but everybody was cool. I mean, everybody was positive, you know, so it just made the experience super enjoyable. And it was full on, lots of hours, so, you know, tiring, long days, but just an absolute blast. And to be a part of somebody's journey, you know, who gets to go and perform and they get to maybe win a certain amount of money, which could change their careers. And to be a part of that was so fulfilling. So yeah, I absolutely thoroughly enjoyed my time on the show. I was so lucky to be a part of it.
Only who lived that experience knows what was that, because the friends, the energy, the synergy, it was so great. Yeah. I'm so grateful about to take part of that, and I partaked in three, four editions, but the one of them was a Colombian edition that calls Canta Comigo, in Spanish, right? And three editions here in Brazil, two for adults, and now I'm living the experience teen. Did you know that? Now I will do some questions to you, okay, simple questions, and after that we will make some games and take fun. That's okay.
Awesome.
Nowadays, in this time, hard times, right, because COVID-19 and things like that, for what do you think people don't really care about, but they should?
Oh gosh, you're gonna like hit me with the hard questions right from the bat, huh?
Yeah.
Like, boom! What should they care about that they're not caring about? Well, the first thing that comes to mind, because I'm an artist, is the art. I feel like I don't know if it's people in general, but I feel like the people of power kind of seeing arts as not a real job, and we're kind of at the bottom of the totem pole, and it seems like we're just not getting the help that we deserve like other businesses, when I find in times like this, the arts are much more important, because it helps people with their mental health. It helps people, you know, it helps to transform people to a new place in their mind, so that they can kind of abandon the hardships for a while, you know? That as entertainers, we are there to help people feel, you know, and communicate emotionally and things like that. So, and help them to express themselves, give them the motivation and the inspiration to express themselves. So I think that people are not caring enough about the arts and what, how therapeutic and what we can do to help others in this tough time. I think that sometimes people don't take it serious enough, you know, the pandemic, like what's happening and what's going on. And so they think, oh, I can't get it. Oh, it's not gonna hit my family. Oh, it's not gonna hurt me, kind of thing. So they just kind of brush it off, and it puts everybody else in a position where it's like, well, if you don't take it seriously, then we're gonna be in this situation for a much longer time. And I don't know about you, but I've got family in Canada that I wanna see. So I want to be able to travel. I want to play shows again. I want to play live again. I want to travel and, you know, sing again. Like, I love that I can sit and I can record and I can make music. I'm so lucky that I get to do that. But I want an audience, you know, and that's not going to happen if people don't start taking it seriously.
Yeah, I agree totally with you. And the feelings change, the mood changes. We are so more emotional about all the things. And about the concert shows, I had stopped between April and August. In September, I back, but I did only one concert in September. But it was to a few people. About 8 people, only one family. Me and my wife goes there and make some surprise. Oh, it's your birthday, let's go to play to you.
Yeah.
And this month, I back and I had 5 concerts, but short concerts to few people, but I play violin too. And 3 of these concerts was with a violin, some surprise for a birthday and some, it was, I think that all of them was birthday. And all this time I made it on one live, but I think that the people changed the behavior. And about the show we are doing it now, all together now, and taking care about health, using masks, alcohol, right? That we are protecting ourselves, because it's a lot of people we know together now. 100 judges and more than 100 professionals that are working behind the stage. And we make tests of COVID-19 a lot of days, and following the rules of protection and things like that. But that's okay. I think the hard times, stepping by stepping, going away, and we'll back to the normal, but probably not exactly the same normal. Next one. Tell me all experience you lived with your single, One Life.
So should you, because you have one life. One life.
You only have one life.
Don't be afraid to fall.
One Life is one of my favorite songs because of what it means, the message behind it. You can get it everywhere on Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music. It's definitely worth checking out. It's really important, especially the message for nowadays, for what's going on right now, you know, just reminding you that life is short, and sometimes it's important to just live life to its fullest, take risks, and not to fear, because fear gets in our way, and we tend to like go, you know, we all of a sudden think the negative, right, first before the positive. It's just the way our minds are programmed. So it's just reminding us to try to not fear things and just go for it. And if life is getting you down and you're feeling a certain depression or darkness, which obviously this time, you know, is when it kind of is having an impact and effect on people's mental health, to talk about it. It's okay just, you know, to let people know how you're feeling, to open up, call a friend, say, hey, you know, can you come over, let's chat, and not to just suppress it and hold it in. But the video is like in a bright, positive way, gives that message. Filming the video, which we filmed it in Notting Hill here in the UK, in London, and we filmed it over 2 days. And the little girl in the video is Carly. She's actually a family friend, and she's a singer as well, so it was so lovely to have her in the video. But I pulled together a bunch of people I knew from the industry, and got different people from all different cultures as well within the one video, which I love. And it's very bright and colorful, but with a very positive message. And the fact that BBC took a liking to it was just the cherry on the top, you know? And to go in for my BBC interview and be BBC introducing the song of the day and have them play it a couple times was just beautiful. And I remember the program manager came out and was like, that's such a top song, it's such a good song. And it's just like, you know, things like that as an artist, you just feel like you're in the right direction and moving, you know. And it's not that I haven't had interviews or have been on the radio before, but there's something special about the BBC, you know? And then I had to follow it up, and then I was like, okay, I have to release another single that's just as good as One Life. So then I wrote Lioness, which is another motivational song about just, you know, being empowered and living life, like finding your full potential. So even if you were born with nothing and you have nothing going for you, that you can still become something. You know what I mean? You don't have to let your circumstances determine where you go in the future. That everything that you need is within yourself. So that's what Lioness is about. And yeah, that's also, you can find that all over on Spotify and things and iTunes and Apple and YouTube Music. And I have a new single coming out now called Fire. And we just shot the music video for that. So that's going to be out. the song is going to be released probably next week. So just, I'm going to start marketing it, promoting it. So stay tuned for the release date. And it's a very sexy song. It's very different from One Life and Lioness. I'm tapping into the more sexy part of me.
And having a date to release.
The music video is shot, it's done, we shot it, it's coming out mid-November.
Oh,
okay. So I'll be posting the release dates and everything on my social media, so please look out for
Inspire. And I will add here below about the link for your social medias, link to the video, to people that not know yet. And I love this song so much, and I expected that your next song, you'll have a great success. You deserve that. Your works, your songs, your videos are so great, so beautiful, and you deserve that, okay? And I have a sure about that. You will do a huge success.
Oh. Thank you.
When did you start to work in? How old were you?
I was singing, I think, from the time I came out of my mom's belly. Like, I was literally, once I was born into the world, I was musical. You know, I was like, that was it. And I was always, my mom said I came out looking up like this. So I was always inquisitive and wanting to be in the world somehow. but yeah, I was put into dance at the age of 5. And I loved to perform. And my mom was a singer and a music teacher. So every time she was on stage performing, I would want to go on stage. She told me this one story that they were performing once. I think I was 3 or 4 years old, and I just ran on stage in front of the entire choir, stood center in front of everybody, and just started singing in the middle of a concert. So yeah, it's just
You have music in your blood, right? Because you
in my blood, yeah, for sure. In the veins, singing. In the veins.
So I started younger too, and I started to work selling bread with 8 years old in a neighborhood, but 1 hour a day only because I was so
young. Selling what?
Selling bread.
Oh, bread. Yeah. I love.
Yes, because in 1983, my father lost his job, and after that, I don't know if you know, but rotisserie had someone there. Do you know what means rotisserie? No.
Rotisserie.
It's a shop that sells food. It's almost fast food. Ah.
Wow.
Something.
That's crazy.
Something as that's a awesome. Restaurant. Something as a restaurant, but you not eat there. You buy and bring to your home. I don't know, have another name there, but I think that exists there, something like that. No. Let's go then, the last question before the musical games. Yeah. Okay, what are the next challenges that the new singers will face from now on?
It's like a double-edged sword. So we're in a position now where being an independent, this is the best time to be an independent artist because of social media, because we are able to market ourselves like we couldn't do in the past. We needed labels and things to push our music. However, it's all so oversaturated, and now everybody wants to be an artist. So it's harder to gain followers. It's harder to build your following and your fan base. And I think because it's so oversaturated, and I think if you want to get to a certain point in your career where you do sign with a label and you do want to move forward and not be independent forever, that's harder because they look at numbers. They look at your social media numbers. They look at to see how big your following is, you know? So I think that's a bit of a challenge for those starting out. So you could be the most talented person in the world. You could be the best singer, but if you don't have the social media numbers, no one's gonna care, you know?
Yes.
Yeah. And I think also, I think we're in a good position because we have streaming and we're able to now make money from streams and things like that. But you have to have such a high number of streams to really make a living, to really make money. So unless you're doing a lot of live shows, I think financially it's challenging for new artists. That's something that they're gonna struggle with, I think, because no one's really buying albums anymore. No one buys, you know, they just stream. So I think that's gonna be a bit of a challenge. But again, if you do have the numbers, you know, then I think it could really work in your favor. Especially if you're really great at marketing and promoting yourself. Do you agree?
Yes, I agree totally. And the artists need to follow a blue ocean. Do you know that? A red ocean, everybody goes there with his ship. And you get one blue ocean that no one goes there. You need to do something different from everyone are doing. You need to try to find something that is totally different.
Yeah.
Because in this way you can take attention of the people. And it's so hard to find some different thing. It's not easy, right?
Yeah.
But no. Probably this is the way or the path that the new singers probably need to looking for, right?
Yeah, I think individuality is so important.
Yes,
to branding and yourself, the sound, and you know, you listen to the radio. It's so funny because you have people who, you know, because I do songwriting as well. You know, so I'll get messages saying, oh, can you write a song for this and this such and such a person, and can you make it sound like this? And you're thinking, well, don't you want them to do something new and fresh and something that they haven't done before, you know? So yeah, and I think that's kind of, for me as an artist, it took me a long time to find my sound, and I would take a lot of different genres and play with them and see what worked for me and what didn't work for me. And you know, Afrobeat is really like very popular right now, and even before Beyonce came out with her new album, this is something that we were wanting to do for a long time. And the producer is from Namibia, and he does a lot of that type of Afrobeat, Afropop music. But I have a very pop background and sound, and so it's like, okay, let's fuse and mix the two. So more poppy, but with Afrobeat. And there's nobody in the UK doing that. You know, you've got like your Afrobeat artists who are very Afrobeat, and then you've got pop, but nobody's really fusing the two together to make it, you know, more mainstream. I mean, Burna Boy started doing it with, I don't know if you know who Georgia Smith is here in the UK, but she's big. There's a few, like Drake went and did a song with Wizkid. So they're starting to catch on, and they're starting to do a lot of stuff with more African artists. But I was like, oh, this is a unique type of like different vibe and different sound. And so, and it suited me so well. And I was like, yes, this is my lane, this is my niche. So what I do is like Afro pop. But it's more pop than Afro, but it's still, you know.
Yeah, but that's it.
And, but still mainstream.
Yes, it's a blue ocean. Your sound is so different. You are finding your blue ocean.
Thank you. But it took me a long time to find the blue ocean. Now I just got to swim deeper in that ocean, you know?
And because that, the success are coming. Are you feeling that? You are doing international interview and a lot of views in the YouTube and social medias.
You're so sweet. Thank you.
So good there. Now it's time to play games. Woohoo! The funniest part of the show.
Yay!
Nice.
I choose one word and you sing the passage of any song that contains that word, okay? The word is name.
Name. Say my name.
Yes.
I know the rest of the words.
You are so good.
Say my name.
Okay. You win.
Now. Beyonce, it's destiny now, isn't it?
Now, the first point. One for you and zero to me yet. Okay. Now you choose one word. Yes.
Okay.
Any word.
One.
5 minutes later. 2 hours later.
Oh God, can you help me?
Oh yeah, I can sing my song.
Yeah.
One life.
You only have one life.
One life. You only have one life. One life.
I don't believe in it. Oh God.
One.
2 points to
what
you.
Else? What else?
Okay. Now another word, let me think. Love.
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 There's so many songs with love.
And I will always love you. I will always love you.
Look.
Whitney.
Oh God. Whew. So beautiful. Thank you for you.
Aww.
Thank you for I'm hearing your voice at now. Oh God. Thank you for this opportunity. Now you choose one word. I will try it.
Okay. You.
You. She loves you, yeah. She loves you, yeah. She loves you, yeah. Woohoo! 1 point to me.
Oh, I love your voice. I love your voice too.
Thank you
so
much.
Well done. That's such a good one.
Now the last word for you. Imagining.
Imagining. can I just do imagine?
Imagine all the people
living for today.
Yes.
Now the last.
Did that work? Did I get that one?
Yes, the last one.
Okay.
Choose one to me now.
For me to you?
Yes.
You win? Okay. Time.
Time. This time I want a little life to live it again. But have another one from Scorpions. Time. And time. To live it again. I have another one. A lot of songs with this word, time. Okay, very well. But you win. Because you made 4 points, the highest score. Yeah, congrats.
I'm happy.
Yeah. Now the next game we'll use a roulette, and I got a roulette here, the two roulettes. The first one roulette get a name of songs. That we will do a lottery, and another one, musical styles. And we will choose one song to sing in different musical style, okay? Hey Vera, my wife, come here, my wife. This is Vera, my wife, HunnyB.
Hi,
nice.
Hello.
Hi, lovely to meet you.
Let me show you. This roulette is here, look. Ooh. And the song is Sweet Dreams. Oh God. Now let me check the styles. Hard rock. Oh God.
Good luck.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Wow!
Woohoo! Let's go to check the next one! Woohoo! Take on me! Woohoo!
That's you again!
Let me check the style! Blues! Oh God! Blues again!
Blues is tough.
Yes, yeah, it's tough.
We're talking away. I don't know what I'm saying. I'll say it anyway. Today's another day.
The next, woohoo! Cross your fingers. What will be the next song? Greatest love of all. What will be this style? Heavy metal.
No. Oh my gosh! Okay. I have to do that.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Children's laughter. Remind us how we used to.
Have you thought about to sing heavy metal before?
Never in a million years, but I'd be like doing the heavy metal.
Nice to meet you.
But I think it was so fun. Oh my gosh.
Oh my God! Wow!
Another one! What will be the next one? You gotta be!
You gotta be?
Yes!
You gotta be old, you gotta be wiser. Yeah, yes. You gotta be hard.
What will be the style? The musical style? Opera!
Oh, okay! This one I can do. Well,
oh,
try.
So well. Let's go in to check then.
All right. Where does it go?
Listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try to keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry.
Yeah! So great! So great! So beautiful voice! Oh God! You can sing heavy metal, you can sing opera, you can sing pop, Afro pop, right? A lot of style. You get a lot of oceans in front of you, right?
Oh,
you know
goodness.
That, you know.
I think I'll stick to my style though. I'll let the professionals do their opera and their heavy metal, and I'll leave them to it.
You have another options if you want. You have other options if you need in the future. Who knows? Now, thank you, Vera, for your partaking with us.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice.
Take
to
care.
Meet you.
All the best. Oh,
nice,
bless you.
Let's go down to the last part. It's ending up. Oh God. The last part calls ping pong questions. I'll do unexpected questions. You answer faster than you can. Let's go then. First question. Have you ever ridden a motorcycle? Wait. And your answer, yes?
I've been on the back of it, yeah.
Another question.
Have you ever passed the wind in an embarrassing situation?
Yes.
What's your mobile phone model and do you like it?
Samsung Note, and I'm getting a new one.
Yeah.
So I'm getting the flip.
Hey.
But yes, I love
that. Did you ever win and sports day events?
Yes.
Have you ever raised money for charity?
Yes.
Have you ever been kayaking?
No.
No. Have a lot of opportunity here in Brazil.
What would be your dream car?
Probably a Rolls Royce. No. A Bentley.
Are you scared of flying?
No.
Have you ever given someone a handmade present?
Yes.
What's your favorite pizza? Wait.
Favorite pizza? Chicken and pineapple and cheese and hot peppers.
Mm. I'm hungry right now because of that. It's your fault. Okay, but now I have a bad news because our show is ending up. But it was, I'm so glad to receive you here, crossing the ocean and come here in my screen and I seeing you right now. I'm so glad to it. And that's okay, HunnyB.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me and thank you for reaching out. And honestly, when this whole COVID thing is over, and if I ever am in Brazil, you know you'll be the first one, because I really want to come visit your beautiful country. And I hope that all the shows All Together Now goes well for you and your beautiful wife. And wishing you all, you know, the successes that you also deserve as well. And before we go, can I just give my social medias? Is that okay?
Okay, please.
You can find me. Is that okay? All right, so you can find me on, first of all, thank you all for watching and thank you all for, you know, supporting us artists and musicians. It means the world to us because this is our job and this is what we do and we love and what we love to do. And we couldn't do it without you. Please follow us. There's lots of information. My new single's coming out, so there'll be a lot of information on that. On Instagram, you can follow me at It's Me HunnyB, ITSMEHUNNYB. And then it's the same on Facebook and it's the same on Twitter. It's Me HunnyB. And yeah, send me a message and I will. I always reply to everybody. So I look forward to hearing from you all. Is that a fish tank behind you?
Did you see? A lot of notes, musical notes.
I know, it's the first thing I saw.
Let me think. I think that's that. Alia, oh God, what happens with this roulette?
Yay.
Now look.
So 1 second, my dog is trying to get in. My dog is trying to get in, 1 minute.
Okay. Oh, I'm so thirsty. You are so smart.
I know, I have water. Is that a... Why? Thank you.